patients come to our office looking for dental implants. We evaluate to see if they're a candidate. Sometimes they're not a candidate right now and need what is called a bone graft or a sinus augmentation or a sinus lift. So the next question is always, what is a bone graft? What is a sinus lift? Many times people decline treatment because they don't fully understand what it is and have a fear because of the term sinus lift. To be honest, the sinus lift is probably the most successful bone grafting procedure that is done, despite the scary name. So a dental implant is a man-made root that is placed into the bone. This root is made out of titanium and is usually between 3.5 millimeters to 5 millimeters wide. We need adequate bone in order to place the implant. We need to have at least 1 millimeter around the implant. So if it's 5 millimeters wide and we need 1 millimeter on each side, then we need a width of about 7 millimeters. Now, an x-ray won't necessarily tell us if you have enough width. Most common x-rays that every dental office has won't tell us the width. It might tell us the length, but not the width. So the only way to determine the adequate width is something that's called the cone beam, CBCT or CT scan of the jawbone. What we can do is look at this jaw from a different angle than normal and look at its actual width. A dental implant is a three-dimensional object, and a two-dimensional x-ray isn't going to give us enough information. Many times a molar tooth is missing, and so to place an implant in that area, we would need to add bone to make it long enough because the sinus has what's called pneumatized. Now, depending on how much bone is there, there's two different approaches that we can do with a sinus lift. There's a crestal approach and there's a lateral approach. The crestal approach is simply we would make what's called the osteotomy or the hole where we will place the implant and place it in its normal position, but not as deep as we hope. And then we can actually push the membrane up and tent it or lift the membrane. We can add some bone particles or other materials into this space that then we let heal. So in some cases, we can place an implant at the same time as the lift itself. And sometimes we have to do it in two stages, meaning we place the bone, we let it heal, and then at a later date, we will then go back in and place the implant. Now, a lateral lift is when there's not that much bone there. We can't push from underneath. And so we have to make an incision on the side of the jawbone and then access the membrane and lift it out of the way. At that point, we will place particulates or other materials so that we can then allow the jawbone to heal. Usually on a procedure like this, we have to let it heal completely, which is usually about 6 to 9 months. As with any dental implant treatment, time is the most misunderstood aspect of treatment. Quite often, we are looking at, rather than weeks, with most dental treatment, we're looking at many, many months and maybe sometimes a couple years.